वेलकम टू पार्ट डी ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 6, दैट इज कंट्रोलिंग सर्वो मोटर यूजिंग आर्ड्यूनो. इन पार्ट सी वी हैव सीन हाउ टू प्रोग्राम सर्वो मोटर विथ आर्ड्यूनो टू रोटेट दैट फ्रॉम 0 टू 180 डिग्री एंड फ्रॉम 180 डिग्री टू 0. सो वी हैव सीन द प्रोटीज सिम्युलेशन टू. बट हियर कंटिन्यूसली द मोटर हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड विथ एंगल्स ऑफ 0 डिग्री, 1 डिग्री अप टू 180 डिग्री एंड बैक फ्रॉम 180 डिग्री टू 0 डिग्री. But what if user wants to write his own angle on the motor? That is, what if the user want to control the, that is, position of servo motor? So in that case, you need to use a potentiometer. So here the demonstration can be done by using the potentiometer. Here, so let us do that. Now here the connection, the second program that here we are going to discuss is, instead of controlling the servo motor from 0 to 180 degree, continuously from 0 to 180 degree and back from 180 degree to 0, why not to control that with variable resistor? So here if I place, because we have discussed in previous session how to use analog pins of Arduino, because suppose at A0, suppose if I place a variable resistor over here, that is nothing but my pot, and if I read the value of this variable resistor and in accordance with that value, suppose if I try to rotate this motor. So we will consider this configuration now. So at A0 we will consider the potentiometer. So potentiometer is continuously by changing this variable knob, you can change the resistance, and accordingly the voltage developed here is also going to be changed. Okay, so A0 is nothing but here, if you remember, this is nothing but the pin which is going to give us digital value. So corresponding analog voltage is going to be converted to its digital value. So how that conversion is happen, that we have seen in our last practicals. Okay, so why not to combine this with this practical? Okay, so here accordingly I need to draw the setup here. So here I need to connect a potentiometer at pin number A0. So I have connected 1K potentiometer at A0, and here I am going to provide the power to it. Then I am going to ground this. Okay, so power this for, let us say, plus 5 volt. Okay, so plus 5 volt. So this is nothing but the setup. Now we will go into Arduino IDE and discuss the setup for that. So obviously the setup will remain as it is for rest of the part, because this part is there, because our servo motor is going to be connected to pin number 9. All these connections will be there. But here we are making, that is, rotation of this servo motor in accordance with change in this resistance, so that user can control the position by varying the resistance. Okay, so now everything in this program will remain same. So let us review that. Hash include servo.h is going to tell Arduino IDE that you are going to use servo library. Here servo my servo is going to create the object for your servo motor. Pot pin equal to 0 means here analog pin we have initialized to 0. Here the value is the variable to read the, store the value which is actually there on pin A0. Similarly, in a setup, there is a similar setup, that is my servo.attach 9 means attaches servo motor on pin number 9 of Arduino. Now this part is nothing but analog read of pot pin in the loop. Means here analog read of pot pin means here pot pin we have connected to which pin? Pin number 0 of Arduino. Okay. So accordance with that, this statement is going to read the value of that resistor. So value of the potentiometer. So what is the value of this potentiometer? Because potentiometer is going to vary from 0 to, we have connected 1K potentiometer over there. So the voltage is going to be vary. Okay. So in accordance with that voltage, what Arduino IDE is going to do? So this voltage is going to be converted to corresponding digital value. So So as we know that Arduino Uno contains 10-bit resolution ADC. So how many levels will be there? Obviously from 0 to 1023. These things we have already discussed. So the value coming out from this A0 is the number which is going to be there from 0 to 1023. So we need to actually map that to corresponding value. So this map function in Arduino ID is going to map the potentiometer value in between 0 to 1023, because here the angle is going from 0 to 180 degree and we are going to map that with we are going to map 0 to 1023 with values from 0 to 180. So the thing is simple, that is here this pin is going to give us value from 0 to 1023 for corresponding variation in our resistance. And here motor is going to rotate from 0 to 180 degree. So what the map function does? Map function maps every value from this 0 to 1023 to values in between 0 to 180 degree, because we are going to rotate the motor from 0 to 180 degree. So suppose here the A0 pins read some value, let us say 225. So corresponding voltage is going to be there and that is converted to digital value of 225. So again, level of 225 is going to be converted with some corresponding degree level over here. And that by that degree, the motor is going to be rotated. Similarly, if you vary the resistance and again the value read is, let us say 550, the level read by the analog read function is 550. So map function, what this map function is going to do? Map function is going to map this 550 in between 0 to 180 range. So y, so suppose some y degree. So the motor is again going to be shifted to y degree. Okay, so in this way it is going to work. So depending upon variation in resistance, the servo motor shaft is going to change its position. Okay. So this is the way here the program is going to be there. So mapping the value from 0 to 1023 to 0 to 180 and value is nothing but that value. Okay, so this is nothing but range to map. So we are going to write our servo motor with this new mapped value. Okay, so obviously that value will be in between 0 to 180 degree only. Okay, and with delay of 50. So now let us verify this code and put it on the Proteus. So done compiling means I have verified with this code. So as like our previous process, I am going to copy this. And I am going to paste it over here. Okay, now this setup is ready to work with the code. So I am going to run the setup now. So I have run the setup. See here, the motor is not rotating because we have not varied the resistance. Now see, if I vary this resistance, in accordance with that, my motor is going to rotate now. So if I say that the resistor percentage is 71% of 1K, okay, I have taken over here. So you can actually here note down the, if you place here voltmeter, you will get the voltage also. Now the motor stops because I am not varying the resistance. So now the control is in my hand. Okay. Now the control is in my hand. So let us put here voltmeter over here so that you will come to know the things. Okay, now I am going to run the set. So see here, now the voltage is 1.65 here like this. If I vary the resistance, the voltage is going to be increased. And see, the motor is going to be rotated on the right side. So shaft is rotated on the right side with different angles. I am going to do that. Okay. Now if I, so now the motor stops because I am not wearing. So what I want to say is the control is in now my hand. So user can control the shaft of motor via simple pot. Okay. So on the left hand side by the same amount. So by changing this resistance value, by changing this supply voltage, you can change the different positions of motor. Okay. So these are nothing but the things which can be possible with Arduino IDE within just 4 to 5 statement of codes. Okay. And the reason is the libraries. So in this practical, the new thing that we have learned is the library, servo.h. So this study of the library is not limited to servo.h. Similar such libraries for different peripherals are available. So that's why the Arduino is going to be preferred nowadays, because it's easy to control the things. Okay. So now we will discuss with some of the applications of this servo motor. So here we have seen how the servo motor can be rotated through different angle using the servo dot write command. Okay, so you can directly write the angle that you want, or otherwise you can use the potentiometer to have the control of the user to rotate the servo motor. Okay. So now let us go with different applications. So the applications of these kind of servo motors you will find in almost every domain. You can see almost in every domain you are going to see these servo motors. So what are the applications? So it is having applications in all the type of rotary or position related applications. So in cameras, telescope, in antenna, positioning of antenna, you can have the servo, because small servos, because antenna needs to be rotated by different angles depending upon your range. Okay, so in that case the small servos have been kept on your dish so that the antenna is going to be rotated. So in camera also, to change the brightness at the camera lens, there are small servos available. No doubt the types of servos are different, but the technology is same. In robotics, it plays most important application in robotics for robotic arm. So robotic arm is going to automate the process to rotate the robotic arm with different angles. You can use the servo motors. Then on conveyor belt, so conveyor belts are having different applications, industrial applications, that is in packaging, in labeling industry. So you can move the conveyor belt with different angles by placing servo motor behind that conveyor belt. Then you can have the in robotic vehicle. So there are numerous applications where you find the servo, because it's thus just the position control of a shaft. So I am not saying the study is limited to these applications that we are discussing. You can think on your own also that where you can use this servo motor. In the solar tracking system. So what is solar tracking system? The solar tracking system is going to adjust the angle depending upon the sun rays. So to adjust that angle, you can place solar panel. You can place solar panel on the servo motor. So depending upon the sun rays, the solar panel is going to be rotated. So for day, it will be having some different angle. For noon, it will be having different angle depending upon sun rays. So you can automate the process. Okay. So these are nothing but the seeing some textile industries. So you will find these applications almost in every field. Okay. So here we have learned how to control the position of the servo motor with the help of Arduino. Okay. So thank you.